So I stand before you now, stripped of my authority and my position by an unjust decision. But I do not have to be Chief Justice to defend our laws and institutions. Unique. In fact, this attack on my office was preceded by attacks against other independent collegial bodies. The Energy Regulatory Commission, the Commission on Elections, the Commission on Higher Education. Never before have we seen an administration that exploited the intramurals within a collegial body as a proxy war against its head. This was also simultaneously carried out against independent bodies tasked with ensuring accountability and justice in the form of calls for resignation and impeachment of the heads of the judiciary, the Ombudsman, and the Commission on Human Rights, whose budget was nearly reduced to zero. It demonstrates the disregard that this administration has for the Constitution and the rule of law. No wonder that our rule of law index has died to an alarming level, and the international community is increasingly concerned at the emerging lawlessness in our country. Lahat ng ito ay nagsimula nang si President Duterte ay naupo. At isa-isang binatikos ang mga pinuno ng mga nasabing ahensya. At binitbit ang mga mapanira niyang panawagan ng kanyang mga alyado. Thus, the responsibility for the weakening of the rule of law is his. He has admitted that sowing intrigue and planting evidence have been part of his practice. To deflect attention from his guilt, he constantly proclaims that he will resign if proof is shown of his participation in each new debacle for the rule of law. And yet, when reminded of his public pronouncements and the conformable acts of his supporters, he and his people retort, "Is that proof?" And so the list of contradicting words and actions gets longer and longer as he continues to employ his strategy of spreading confusion. But truth has a way of coming out eventually. And he is making a mistake if he thinks the Filipino is so easily fooled.